Alright, first we have go to the start, select mechanical design and assembly design. Here we are going to insert the existing component. Select our corresponding component which we created previously. Click open. Then we have to apply the fixed constraint for engine block. Then we have to insert a few more components. Select our corresponding component and click open. Then we are using a snap move for specify the location of parts. Then we have to use a multi instances to be produced. Select the piston to produce a multi instances. After that, we need to apply the constraints. Select a coincident constraint. Select our corresponding axis of piston and engine block. After that, we need to apply the parallelism constraint. So select the angular constraint. Select our corresponding faces of piston and engine block to apply the parallelism constraints. You have to follow the same procedure for four pistons. Select the face of the piston and the engine block. Apply the parallelism. Click OK. Just follow the same procedure for all pistons. After applying the constraints, you have to just click a move toolbar. Select all the constraints, then hide the constraints. Then we need to insert a few more components. Go to the insert and existing component. Just click here. Smart move for move the inserting component for your corresponding locations. After that, you need to use a multi instances. So we need a four number of connecting rods. So go for multi instances and define the multi instances. You need a three more connecting rods and specify the corresponding locations. After that, we need to apply the constraints between the piston and connecting rod. Select a coincident constraint. Apply between the each piston and each connecting rods. Follow the same constraint for all the pistons and connecting rods. After applying the coincident constraint for all connecting rods and pistons, we need to apply the offset constraint between the piston and connecting rods. So select a offset constraints here. Go to the constraint toolbar and you have to select a corresponding faces of connecting rod and piston. Just specify the offset distance between the two faces is 4 mm. Follow the same procedure for all connecting rods and pistons. Apply the offset constraints between them. Select the two faces of piston and connecting rod. Specify the offset distance as 4 mm, then click OK. Then we have to apply the offset constraints for your last pair of piston connecting rod. Select the corresponding faces of them. specify the offset distance as 4 mm, then click OK. Next we have to select a move toolbar, so select a move toolbar, then you have to specify the corresponding axis of rotation with respect to the constraints to get the required locations. After that you need to move the piston to the upwards with respect to the constraints. Then click OK. Then we have to insert a few more components. Before that we need to hide the all constraints which we created previously for the better visualization of assembly parts. Then just select the existing component to inserting with corresponding product. Select the corresponding component and place it at the required position. By using a smart move, just drag the component and place it at the required positions. Then we have to apply the manipulations here with respect to corresponding axis of rotations. Then we are going to use here coincident constraints between the connecting rod and the crank shaft. Apply the coincident constraints here by specifying the two axes. Now the coincident constraint is successfully applied here. After applying the coincident constraints, we need to apply the offset constraints between the crankshaft and the connecting rod. So select a offset constraints, then you have to select a two faces of crankshaft and a connecting rod. You have to apply the offset distance as 0 mm. It means the two faces must be a contact. After that you need to apply the coincident constraints and offset constraints for all pair of connecting rods and a crankshaft. So follow the same procedure. We have to apply the coincident constraints between the connecting rod and crankshaft. Just apply the coincident constraints for all. Now we have successfully applied the coincident constraints between the connecting rod and the crankshaft. After that we need to move the components for the required locations. Just insert a component which we created previously. Then we have to move a smart move for dragging the newly inserted component. Then we have to use a manipulation ports or angular constraints between the engine block and the flywheel. Apply the parallelism. Then we have to use a manipulating ports, move the components for the required location. Just drag in your corresponding axis based upon your requirement. After that, you have to apply the constraints. Just click OK. Then select a fixed constraints for your flywheel support. Then we have to apply the constraints between the crankshaft and the flywheel support. Then we have to move the all over components for the correct location. So just click here, snap, and track the component towards the upward. Then we need to just again click the snap, move the connecting rod for the required location. Then click OK and update. Just click update. Now all the components are occupy the correct locations. After that, you have to just rotate the component of the crank shaft. The motion will be generated successfully here. You can check it by using the manipulation ports. Before that, we have to just hide the all constraints which we apply here. Then we have to just click a manipulation ports and specify the correct rotation axis, and just you have to drag the crankshaft. Now the motion will be successfully transmitted here. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Thanks for watching. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. If you have any doubts regarding this tutorial, you have to just post in the comment.